So let's talk about an application that is going to make use of some of this. So this is one that I really like. It's basically a chat with an asynchronous updating of the chat data. Okay, and so at the beginning of this, now let's just play with it first. So here is this application running. And basically, the idea is I can say hi, and it says hi back to me. And I can actually open this in a second window as a different person. All right, so I've got two windows now, and both windows are going to see. So I can come over to this window and say window 2, and I hit chat. And I come over here to window 1, and it sees that from window 2, right? So this guy, they are asynchronously updating and getting each other's chats. And the way to see this is the developer console. And what's happening is it's using JSON to get all of the, if I go to network here, it's calling chatlist.php, and it's getting a list of the current chats. And so when I change the current chats, another in window 2, a moment later, it goes and grabs it with another chatlist.php, and so there's a third chat. And so it's using JSON and jQuery and a timer loop to sort of keep all these windows simultaneously up, okay, and going at the same time. Okay, so it's this asynchronous chat. And then I can reset all the chats, and then this guy will reset as well. I don't have to hit the reset both sides because a couple of seconds later. So that's what's going on with this chat. So let's examine some of what's going to happen here. So the first thing that we've got is the standard posting request response cycle stuff. And if it's a reset, we're going to store the chat. We're going to store the chats as just an array in the session, because we don't want to use a database quite yet. And so if we get the reset button set, which we can just say is set post reset, because we named the reset button reset in the HTML, and we change the session, and then we redirect back to ourselves. If there's a message, it actually creates either an empty array if it needs to, but then it puts in the date and the actual message that came in and redirects. Okay, and so that this post will take this array of chats and go ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. And so if we see that in the code, you know, we see this array of chats. We see this array of chats that comes back. Well, now the chats are, it's an array, it's an empty array because I just reset it, okay? Okay, so that is the top part of this file. Then down here in the middle, we load jQuery, and then we go down and we see the chat code. And here we got a basic form that posts back to ourselves. We have a text field, we have a submit. I've got a little link to chatlist.php in here as well. And then we got a reset button. And then we have a div. And it's called chat content with an ID of chat content. We stick this ID in because we can grab that with jQuery, right? And we put a spinner in there. Okay. We put a spinner in there so that it shows loading with an alt text of loading so that the spinner is there while it's loading. Then, continuing down, we have a function called update messages. Okay. And what this basically does is it'll start on a timer every 4 seconds, and we'll talk about how the timer works. It does a log. It does an AJAX call to get some to this URL called chatlist.php. Cache equals false keeps your browser from only retrieving it once and believing that it already has the data. It does this by adding a get parameter of the time so that it forces the browser to get a new one every time. And if we have a success, then we get the JSON data back and we log it. We log the actual data. We empty out the chat content. And you will see that this is on a list. It's a list of an array of arrays with message, comma, date on it. And so we write a for loop. This is a JavaScript for loop, right? And so for var equals I less than data to length I plus plus, that's going to loop through all the chat messages. And then it pulls out the chat message, and the sub zero entry is the actual message, and the sub one entry is the date of the message. And then once that's all done, so once we have cleared out the chat content and read the data from the return JSON and stuck it into the chat content of div, we empty it out and then we append line, 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 paragraph, paragraph, paragraph. Each of these things is a separate paragraph. And then we do a set timeout. This is a JavaScript call, not a jQuery call, that says wait 4 seconds and then call ourselves again. So update message sort of grabs the data, empties out the chat div, and then puts all the chats in the chat div, and then says call me again in 4 seconds. And so it calls, it defines the function, then says startup complete, and then it calls update message once at the beginning of the program to get the whole thing started. So it retrieves the messages right away. Now, one of the things I should probably do here is I should probably just put this sleep in all the time. In chatlist.php, all it does is it sends back JSON to our application. And sleep 5 makes it so the thing moves slowly enough so we can see what's happening. And I should probably just leave the sleep 5 in all the time. And so header content, so we put a header, a content type header in. This is good hygiene. Everything we've done so far, it's been application text content type, but by telling it it's real JSON, that's good. So this is a good thing to put into before any data has been sent. It's another header, just like location header, except this is a content type header saying what I'm about to send you is not just HTML, it's not text, it's not a JPEG image, it is actual JSON, and it's going to be in UTF character set. So I just check to see if I have any chats yet. If I don't, I create an empty array, but then I simply echo using JSON encode the variable that's in session chats, which is an array of two item arrays where the message and the date, message, date. And so it just takes this whole thing, JSON encode, turns that into a string and echoes it out. So we will see chatlist.php. Okay. So let me show you sort of again how that works. Let me go in first. Oops, come back. Hang on. So in chatlist.php, I'm gonna uncomment this 5 second sleep just because it makes it easier to see what's going on. Okay. So I'm gonna clear the console log and then sort of start fresh. I'm going to hit index.php, and what we see is we see the spinner because we haven't yet overwritten what's in the chat content div. So there's a chat content div. Go back and take a look. There's a chat content div. Now we've asked for chatlist, but chatlist is taking a long time. So, but finally chatlist came back, and so we got no chat messages, but we did overwrite the spinner. So the spinner's gone now. Okay. So now I'm going to go over into the other window and I'm going to type yo. And then I'm going to come back and we're waiting. And at some point our 4 second timer is going to expire. But remember it sleeps 5 seconds. So it's going to be around 9 seconds. So at some point down here, there we go. So at some point we did this JSON request. It's going to happen every 4 seconds now. We did this JSON request and we emptied out that chat content div. And then we got back an array of arrays. So this is the first element of this is the message. The second element is the date of the message. So we loop through this little list. We wiped this out, and then we loop through the list and put it in. So I'm going to go over in the other screen, and I'll put a second message in. So I'm going to hit chat. Now we'll come over here, and in a moment, it's going to do another 4 second timeout and then 5 second delay, and then it will get another one. So here we go. We just got another one. I think. Oh, it's waiting. It's not done yet. It's starting. Now we got a response. So that was the 5 seconds, okay? So now you see we have two messages. So the little JavaScript for loop clears this whole div out, and then it loops through and prints out the message and the date of the first one, the message and the date of the second one, and it puts that thing out. And so that's how we achieve this, right? It's basically, if we take a look at the code, we are having every 4 seconds call this function, and then we get some JSON, we ask for the URL chatlist.php, and when this is done, it calls our success function after it's parsed the data. So it's really in JavaScript as an array at this point. So we write a little for loop and make a little paragraph for each of the entries. And the 0 entry is the message and the 1 entry is the date. So again, this is all pretty simple stuff, but you can kind of see how you can compose these things to have jQuery cause JavaScript to happen with a timer, to use JSON, and then change the DOM. So we're sort of flipping between JavaScript and jQuery, and eventually we're changing the document object model without a full request response cycle.